with Nicole Duncan this morning from NickelSearch. Nicole, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. Great to see you.
Well, this is exciting. Drilling underway here at some of these Greenfield nickel sulphide targets at Carlingup. Tell us a bit more about what's planned.
Great. So the rig, it's an RC rig, and it's at Serendipity, which is a target that we don't have any historical drilling for nickel sulfides that we can really use. So we've had airborne EM, magnetics, and soil sampling results, and Serendipity's responded well to those, particularly the soil sampling. So we're really keen to get the holes in the ground and get to understand Serendipity a bit better. It'll be very interesting. We're putting three RC holes in there for 150 each.
And in the announcement, you say following Serendipity, B1, that's the next cab off the rank, is it?
That's right, Andrew. So B1 is just over a short stream from Serendipity. It's not too far to move. But at B1, we've had historical drilling there that has hit nickel intersections. So we're really excited to get back in. It was hitting nickel at 1%. And so we're putting nine holes into B1 in order to understand the geology there, the structure there better. And then if the weather holds and we get those POWs in time, which, you know, we're hopeful the department will grant those to us, we'll get across to Lipple and Wadley. But we're just at the moment concentrating on Serendipity and then B1.
And significantly, you've received some EIS co-funding here. What will this be for?
Yes, so we put in an application for the co-funding because this is a hole that has been studied by the University of Tasmania Codes Group, and they looked at a previous hole that was drilled in 2011. They took the core of that and they assessed it for prospectivity for VMS, base metals. And so they said that it is the closest that they'd seen to a DeGrussa-style mineralization, that is a sandfire copper gold mine. So we're really keen to get back and look at that target area.
And so what will some of your early work be here?
Yeah, so we've got the next few months to do the early work, and we'll, you know, actually revisit the hole and see the state of it, see if we can get back down into it, even just to do downhole EM. So we'll test it. But then we've, since we've started, we've got a lot more information about that particular area. So we've gone and done airborne EM, we've got magnetics, we've got soil samples, we've had all of this reviewed by experts. And so I think that we can take what we know about the hole itself, the historical hole, and analyze it with a whole bunch of new information and make sure that we're drilling in the right location to get the best amount of information for what's deep, deep, deep. It's, you know, we're looking at a hole that's 500, 600 metres deep.
Good to speak. Thanks for your time.
Thank you so much, Andrew.